issue of cricket, which is running out the non-striker, or famously known as mankading. Well, for those who are not aware of this, let's watch a video and understand what exactly it's about. When the bowler is in his run-up and before he releases the ball, the batsman moves out of his crease. Seeing this, the bowler stops his run-up and puts the wickets down. This is termed as running out the non-striker or mankading. Well, many of the people believe that a warning should be given to the batsman before attempting the run-out in this fashion. And some other set of people even believe that running out the non-striker in this fashion is not even within the spirit of the game. So what do you guys think about this? Now let's see what exactly cricket law has to say about this. If the non-striker is out of his ground from the moment the ball comes into play to the instant when the bowler would normally have been expected to release the bowler is permitted to attempt to run him out. One term to be noted in the law is moment the ball comes into play. The ball comes into play after the bowler starts his run-up. If the bowler doesn't have any run-up, then the ball comes into play when he starts the action to deliver the ball. So, the bowler is allowed to attempt the run-out only after the ball comes into play. So, the law clearly states that the bowler is allowed to run out the non-striker if he's out of the crease before the bowler completes his action. Now, let's watch few videos to understand this law better. In this case, the bowler puts down the wicket before even he enters the delivery stride and the batsman is out of his crease. Non-striker is out in this case. In this case, the bowler enters his delivery stride but he doesn't swing his arm. Instead, he stops and puts down the wicket. And the batsman is out of his crease. Non-striker is out in this case. Well, the bowler is allowed to run out the non-striker in this fashion as well. Next case is a trickier one which involves two laws. Let's watch. To plain sight, this looks like not out, isn't it? Before coming to conclusion, let's take a look at a statement of cricket law which talks about bat being held in batsman's hand. It states that contact between a batsman's hand or glove worn on his hand and any part of the bat shall constitute the bat being held in that hand. It means that bat is valid only when it is held in hand. So in this case, though the body of the batsman is in contact with the bat, it is not considered valid as he is not holding the bat in his hand. So he will be given out. In this case, the bowler enters his delivery stride, swings his arm as well, but doesn't release the ball. And then he goes on to put the wicket down. Well, this is where the law prohibits the bowler from misusing it. As we have seen, the law clearly tells that the bowler is allowed to run the batsman out till the instant when the bowler would have normally been expected to release the ball. So, this is the point where the bowler is normally expected to release the ball. But the bowler doesn't release the ball and then tries to run out the batsman. This is not allowed and the batsman will not be given out, though he is out of his crease. Law further states that whether the batsman is out or not in this attempt, the ball won't be counted. So all you bowlers out there, you know what exactly to do if the batsman leaves the crease before you complete the bowling action. Well, if you are a batsman, make sure that you are at your safety.